asteroids with rings around them, a new accurate measurement to the center of our galaxy, and the largest 360-degree panorama of the Milky Way. Hello, space fans. Welcome to another edition of Space Fan News. When we imagine asteroids, the image that pops in our head, more often than not, is of a cold, rocky body floating in space somewhere between Mars and Jupiter, what we call the asteroid belt. With that in mind, imagine the surprise of astronomers when they observed a large Centaur asteroid with rings around it. The object's name is Chariklo, and astronomers were caught off guard when they observed these rings as this minor planet crossed the path of light of a star behind it. Astronomers have been waiting since June of 2013 for when Chariklo would occult the far-off star, and boy was it worth it. When going over the data, astronomers noticed distinct dips in light a few seconds before and a few seconds after Chariklo went in front of that star. Now, since not only one telescope was used, but seven telescopes from across the world, this data was easily confirmed. Chariklo was first discovered by James Scotty in 1997, and its orbit is actually between Saturn and Uranus. It gets the Centaur designation because it acts like an asteroid and a comet, and thusly after the mythological creature that is half man, half horse. Now, scientists aren't exactly sure as to how the rings formed, but the most likely scenario is that it's the result of an impact that happened a long time ago with the ejected debris that didn't reach escape velocity to find a stable orbit around it. Up until this time, there's been no reason to think that objects this small would have rings around it. But here you go, two distinct rings around Chariklo. You know, I guess Beyonce was right. If you like it, you better put a ring on it. And whatever was hitting on Chariklo did exactly that. Radio astronomers from three international teams have given us the most precise measurement from our solar system to the center of the Milky Way, 27,190 light years. NRAO's Very Long Baseline Array, the European Very Long Baseline Interferometry Array, and the Japanese VERA project all work together to find this accurate distance, which is said to be within a 2% margin of error. Or as Mark Reed from the Harvard-Smithsonian Center for Astrophysics said, more accurate than road sign mileages. So what's the big deal? What does knowing exactly how close to the galactic center we are do for us? Well, just like other units of measurements that we use in our everyday lives, they're based off of other measurable things. A liter, for instance, is a volume of 1,000 centimeters cubed. And a light year is the distance that light travels in a vacuum in a Julian year. We're able to use these units of measure by precisely measuring the components that make them up. A light year would be useless to us if we weren't able to accurately measure the velocity of light within a vacuum. The same goes with knowing our distance to the center of the Milky Way. It allows us to better understand the mass and motions of objects throughout the galaxy, as well as their luminosity. So studying this light with a better understanding of how far away it is gives us better insight into what's going on in our stellar neighborhood. So since we're inside the galaxy, it makes it very difficult to do things like map it, kind of like not seeing the forest because of all those trees in the way. These precise techniques have produced results that are going to be more accurate than when Gaia goes online. But the silver lining in this is that Gaia is not just looking in towards the center of our galaxy, but looking at 1 billion stars of our galactic neighborhood. So this data from Gaia will actually be complemented by the techniques radio astronomers are using, so we can better understand our Milky Way. Finally, speaking of the Milky Way, one of the most beautiful panoramas I've ever seen of it was just released at TED in Vancouver. It's a completely interactive 360-degree galactic view in infrared wavelengths thanks to the data of the Spitzer Space Telescope. The team from Wisconsin took 10 years of Spitzer data, stitched it together to make this awe-inspiring image. This Glimpse 360 picture was compiled by Barb Whitney of University of Wisconsin-Madison. You want to know what the best part is? You can get in and play with the imagery yourself. It's been released as part of Microsoft Research's Worldwide Telescope program, and if you're on a Windows machine, I definitely recommend downloading the program and running it from inside. However, if you're not, that's okay, because you can still run Worldwide Telescope within an internet browser. Make sure to click the links below in the description to get access to this fantastic free tool. You won't regret it. Well, that's it for this week, space fans. Tony and I are both looking forward to hanging out with you tonight at 9 p.m. Eastern, 6 p.m. Pacific for Space Fan News Live. Don't forget to bring your questions and comments so we can respond to them live on air. Follow us on Twitter, and please don't forget to subscribe. Thank you all for watching, and as always, keep looking up.